Hello everyone, my name is Grethade, and I'm a member of the Noobcast podcast. This is Gaming News Headlines. Now, this was a series I used to do back in, 2012. It was a 3 times a week video series that just was so time consuming trying to do 3 times a week when this wasn't my job. That said, I'm making a few tweaks, looking to try to bring back this series, and just trying to be a little more efficient with everyone involved. That said, Game in the Background is Just Cause 2. Yes, I realized Just Cause 3 recently came out. Yes, I realized Just Cause 3 looks better. But the destruction in Just Cause 2 is just as entertaining. With that said, let's see what happened this week. Not a lot happened this week, but we'll go take a look anyway. First up, the highly anticipated MMORPG Blade&Soul launched in North America and Europe on January 19th. Blade&Soul was known for its movement mechanics, which allowed players to glide and soar through the world within the game. Of course, with the launch of such a highly anticipated game, also meant the launch of incredibly long queue times to get into the world. I was able to create a character. However, after 3.5 hours of waiting in queue, I still had a queue time of 90 minutes before I could get in and play the game yesterday during its launch. The reason for this, NCSoft, the company behind Blade&Soul's launch in North America, set up a mechanic where premium players could leapfrog non-premium players, the people that downloaded the game for free, and could get into the game that way. Now I know what you're going to say. You're going to say, but Grethade, they paid money for the game. Well, sure, they paid money for the game and they had early access to the game. There were people posting pictures from the game this past weekend. That said, the ability to be able to leapfrog everyone that didn't pay for the game to the point where premium players had a queue as well, it just doesn't bode well for the entire stress capabilities of the game. NCSoft should know better behind. NCSoft should know better than that. NCSoft is also responsible for the North American launches of WildStar, Aeon, and the Guild Wars franchise. They know better. They would also know, especially with games like Aeon and WildStar and Guild Wars, that free-to-play players will spend money in-game for microtransactions. So, not too sure what to think of it. I'm definitely going to try to get into it again. Hopefully for the next video, it'll actually be the background video that I intended to have instead of, well, Just Cause 2. That explains why it's there. Speaking of Korean MMOs, another highly anticipated MMO, Black Desert, recently released its character creator. Now, for those that don't realize why this is actually a big deal, is Black Desert received a lot of attention last year when video footage from the character creator of this game was released to the internet. The character creator had the ability to manipulate just about anything you could imagine in this world. The characters could have long limbs, they could have long fingers, they could have long legs, they could have short... Look, you could do just about anything you could imagine with these characters. There was some footage I saw where a character had a wave in one part of her hair and that was it. You can get detailed to the hair structure, to the facial structure, to the body structure, to the limb structure, to the appendage structure. Now, this, of course, is ahead of next month's second closed beta test, which is at the mid to end of February timeframe, which is just in time to make sure all the nooks and crannies and things have been worked out and all the bugs have been tested out in this game so it could launch by its Q1 goal date. Regardless, having a character creator that is this detailed launched ahead of the game is a great way for players to experience what it's like to have their own avatar ready to go for the game and hook them by the time the game launches. Go check it out. You can find it on Black Desert's website. Of course, if you do that, just remember there is 7 GB worth of data to download. And, of course, the last thing I could find for news this week is that Bravely Second, the sequel to Bravely Default, is announced to release in North America on April 15th of 2016. players that really appreciate the franchise will also have a collector's edition available, which will contain a 250-page art book and a 10-track soundtrack. For those that don't realize what Bravely Default is, Bravely Default is the spiritual successor to classic JRPGs such as the original Final Fantasy series. So we're talking Final Fantasy 1 through 6. If anyone is a fan of the JRPGs of the mid and early 90s, Bravely Default is a fantastic game to check out, and it's easy to carry with you because it's available on 3DS. Of course, the art is also phenomenal, so that art book is very, very tempting. And that should do it for this video. Now, like I mentioned, I am making a few tweaks. Instead of trying to do this 3 times a week, which is a ton of work for someone that doesn't get paid for this, and this is flat out a passion project, I'm going to bring back gaming news headlines once a week. Instead of 3 stories, we're going to try to get 5 or 6 in there, and we're going to try to find the hardest hitting or the biggest news headlines of the week. More on that to come as far as what day to expect that, but we're going to try to get that on a schedule so you know when it will launch. I will work on that. That said, with that coming up, and I'm going to start doing that in February. If you have any feedback about this video, whether it be positive or negative, please leave it in the comments section down below. That said, please, 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 please let it be constructive criticism. If you come in and just go, "Your video fucking sucks," that doesn't help me make my videos better. Please, please, dear God, tell me what makes my videos good or not good, and let me know. I can apply that to future videos and make them better. If you did like the video, I appreciate it. Give me a thumbs up and let me know that you liked it. And with that said, I'll catch you guys next time.
That was fun!
It was a design flaw, that's all.